manager of Ford Europe. He's with me now. Martin, what is the problem? What needs changing?
So, Richard, good evening here from Copenhagen. Thank you very much for having me. First of all, let me say we are investing a lot of money. $2 billion are going into a new plant in Cologne in Germany at the moment, where we are building exclusively electric vehicles. We are fully committed to turning our whole product lineup into electric vehicles by 2030. And of course, we would like to sell our electric vehicles everywhere, also in the UK. But because of the Brexit deal, we would have to pay tariffs for our vehicles we are shipping from Europe to the UK, which of course means prices in the UK for electric vehicles
right.
go up. And
so getting to the bottom, sorry,
down.
if I could just jump in here, getting to the bottom of the reason why. This is all about the 45% rule, isn't it, from the both sides, and actually the batteries and other components that are non-EU UK would force it into a tariff-driven environment.
So the situation is that this tariff applies to electric vehicles. It does, of course, not apply to vehicles with internal combustion engine. So on the one hand, the UK is committed to increasing the share of electric vehicles dramatically, but the import of vehicles with combustion engine would be much more favorable in comparison with electric vehicles. And of course, this absolutely does not help the ambition of the government and also what customers want, because we know that electric vehicles are the better cars, and there's a high demand for affordable electric vehicles also in the UK.
So I'm assuming you and all the major car makers are lobbying as hard as you can amongst many other people. Are you confident that a post-Brexit deal will be done to put this right?
We are confident that there will be a deal, because simply this is what is the better solution for the consumers. We know consumers want electric vehicles, they want affordable electric vehicles, and the current regulation does not really support expectation and demand from consumers, predominantly in the UK. And this is why we are confident that things will be put right by the end of the year.
And the transition to electric will continue at the pace necessary, because as our previous gist said, we are in danger of seriously now not making the 1.5 degrees.
That is correct. And that is why all automakers are putting a lot of money in electrifying their fleet. We are 100% committed by 2030 already. Each and every passenger vehicle in a Ford showroom in Europe will be an electric vehicle. And the good thing is, electric vehicles are just the better cars. Instant acceleration, smooth ride, much more space, because the electric drivetrain is smaller than the internal combustion engine drivetrain. So there will be very, very strong demand. And this is why I'm confident that we can do our part to bringing CO2 emission down quite quickly.
Martin, I'm glad you joined us tonight. Thank you. Putting it into perspective for us.
Thanks.